Hi, welcome to the Friday Five. It is Friday, October 11th. Hope you're having a great week. Well, they say we're turning the real estate industry upside down. There's my proof. Let's see what happened this week. Earlier this week at Caldy's, we had a good social hour. Good conversation there. Got to talk about open houses and some other things. I would encourage you, if you haven't done this already, there's two things I would put in your schedule for sure. On a recurring basis, just automatically recurring so that you remember them. One would be our online More Office meeting, which is on the first Tuesday of every month at 9:30. Even though it's recorded and available on the forum, it is better to be there live. Gives us an opportunity for a little bit of interaction, gives you an opportunity to ask questions and get some clarification on things that are discussed. Also, it does encourage for I guess more participation when we do have guests that appear on the meeting as well. And the second date that I'd put on there would be the second Tuesday of every month at 9:30 for our social hour. It's 1 hour a month that we get to come together face to face, and it's a nice time for us to be able to visit and have an unstructured opportunity or an unstructured meeting, just kind of a free fall, free for all, if you will, free form is what I'm trying to say, meeting. Just to get together. What else? A couple of housekeeping items. A couple of issues that come up quite often is just a reminder, if you're going to do designated agency, which is not a bad idea, when you're doing the buyer's agency agreement or listing agreement, you must send the listing agreement or the buyer's agency agreement to me via DocuSign for me to sign for more. You can't sign your own agreements if you are going to be a designated agent. If you're not going to be a designated agent, you're going to be purely a buyer's agent or a seller's agent, then you can sign the agreement yourself. Also, we do not allow sub-agency here. So your listing agreements should say zero for sub-agency in terms of what's being offered in terms of compensation. When you put listings in the MLS, that should also say zero. Let me think. I think that's all the housekeeping items. What's new in the forum? This week in the forum, a lot of things are new. The forum is new. As you see here, the forum took on a new look. I gave it a new look earlier this week. A little cleaner, a little more modern look. Hopefully you like that. There's some new things in the forum as well. For starters, the St. Louis Market Update video for October is there. Also, all of you are subscribed to get the email update with the link with the market update video. I would encourage you to take the 5 minutes it takes to watch the video and be it's a good overview of the market in general, so you can be up to date on the market. Also, share that link with people in your sphere. Not the link to the forum, because obviously the only people can get in there are agents with a password, but the link that was to the YouTube video. Also new in the forum is how to create a custom email signature, a short video on that in the email section. So if you'd like, and you should be using a custom email signature like I have, that may has a photo in it, logo, contact information, whatever. There's also under 2 minute teasers, there was a new 2 minute teaser I did earlier this week on the Keeper, Password Keeper. Everybody knows keeping track of passwords and all the websites to go to and the login information for everything we deal with is a challenge. So I would encourage you to watch that video and get the Keeper password. What's new on St. Louis Real Estate News? A couple of good articles this week worth sharing because they're very relevant, and I would again encourage you to share them. One was an article on how will the government shutdown affect the St. Louis real estate market. This is a question a lot of people are asking. This is your opportunity to hold yourself out as the expert and also the professional. Email that out to everybody you know with a link and encourage them to read it, that here's the answers to the question they're probably asking. Then there was a second article I did the next day, which is where NAR came out and warned that if there's now an impasse with the debt ceiling, that may run interest rates up and home sales down. Also, speaking of that, if you've not liked St. Louis Real Estate News yet, we're at 199. Please like it. Show some encouragement for us there, if you would. And finally, the market this week. Here's the market action index for the five counties. You can see all the counties, with the exception of St. Louis County and St. Charles County, are in buyer's markets, and those two are headed that way too. That's it for now. There's 5 minutes. Have a great weekend. God bless you.